Right now, we are waking up to some freezing temperatures. Austin is tracking our Saturday morning forecast. And when we could soon see Alliant Energy Center as a federal vaccination site.
This is News 3 Now This Morning.
Good morning, everyone. It is Saturday, February 20th. I'm Taylor Lazenby, and let's get straight to it with our weather this Saturday morning with Austin. Austin, how are you?
Taylor, it's a brutally cold morning outside yet again here this morning, but we are actually going to see some warmer temperatures sneaking through later on this afternoon. And I say warmer, but it's just comparative to what we actually have been seeing. We're looking at some low to mid 20s. Now, later on next week, that's when we're going to see even 30s and 40s returning to the forecast. Three things you need to know: low to mid 20s today, 1 to 3 inches of snow for tomorrow, especially in the afternoon and evening and overnight hours, and mild conditions later on afterwards. Currently, however, it's very cold, still 2 below here in Madison. It got down to 5 below overnight last night, and our temperatures are still slowly working to recover as of right now. Most communities are currently below zero. Now, moving on here for the rest of today, we actually are going to see those warmer temperatures moving through, and that's not going to take very long. By the time we reach noon, we're looking at upper teens and low 20s, so it's really not a bad start to the day. And just a quick peek at what we're seeing in terms of traffic. Right now, it does look like things are moving along quite nicely. No major incidents to report. No major slowdowns either. The main arteries in and out of Madison currently looking pretty good.
All right. Thank you so much, Austin. Well, a new private-public collaborative effort will help make sure teachers and school staff around Dane County get their vaccines as soon as possible. Next month, under a new partnership, public health and local health care providers will join forces to vaccinate school staff at Dane County's Alliant Energy Center. A total of 14,000 vaccines have been requested, and depending on the supply, the effort is expected to take at least 6 to 8 weeks. And members of the federal government did a walkthrough there just last week. The Dane County Executive's Office says that the feedback was positive. If it is chosen, the Alliant Energy Center would distribute as many as 6,000 vaccines per day. And we have more details on the plans and how it will all work on channel3000.com and on our free Channel 3000 news app. And we're getting a visual update on how well the vaccines are working within long-term care facilities in Dane County. You can see here, since the first doses were administered, cases have dropped significantly. This chart is provided by Public Health Madison in Dane County. Residents in these facilities were among the first in the state to be vaccinated. And President Joe Biden traveled to Kalamazoo, Michigan on Friday to visit the Pfizer plant and suburban city of Portage. Now, this is the company's largest production facility and the main production facility for their COVID vaccine. And in Rock County, the medical examiner has identified two people that were killed in a plane crash in Janesville on Tuesday. 25-year-old Tanner Bolham of Gildan in Ashland County and 26-year-old Remington Vinny of Kimberly were killed. Both were pronounced dead at the crash site, about a mile from the Southern Wisconsin Regional Airport. The FAA and the NTSB are investigating. One of those victims, Remington Vinny, graduated from UW-Madison in 2017. Plane crash victim was Madison UW graduate. She was also one of the founding members of the Madison-based Four Lakes chapter of Women in Aviation. In a Facebook post, the chapter said it mourns the life of a young pilot whose life was cut far too short. Back in 2013, she also safely crash-landed a plane near Beaver Dam that was carrying three members of her family when a fuel tank switch broke. She has also served since 2013 in the Wisconsin Air National Guard. And developing right now, two people have been confirmed dead after a military plane went down in Alabama. Local authorities say the jet was flying from Columbus, Mississippi to a base in Florida when it went down in Montgomery County, Alabama. Right now, initial reports say it is believed to be a T-38 jet, which is a two-seater training jet. And a local radio DJ is accused of having child pornography is now out on a signature bond. Matthew Bradshaw Jones, who goes by Jackson Jones on the radio, was in court on Friday afternoon. Now, according to a criminal complaint, Jones is accused of having at least one image of child pornography. Jones told detectives he used the sites Tumblr and Wicker for, quote, sex chats and fantasies, and would pretend to be other people while online. Jones said he would often like to reshare a variety of images on the sites. An assistant DA for Dane County says Jones also offered to traffic two children during those chats. Jones' defense attorney argues his client wasn't serious and didn't actually go through with that.
Given what is alleged here and likely the charges that are possibly going to be added, we might be looking at not just one, but numerous mandatory minimum prison charges, which creates a whole different dynamic.
All it is talk. It's fantasy chat. And I suspect that all of that was put in to the complaint for a couple reasons. One, to grandstand because of who Mr. Jones is. And two, to try to convince you that this is worse than it is.
Now, according to the complaint, Jones told investigators it was just what he calls stupid taboo talk, and also admitted he knows he, quote, threw his whole life away. Now, the judge says Jones can't have any contact with any minors and no access to the internet. And the Janesville man accused of killing a woman inside a Wisconsin Dells hotel room is now charged and being held on a $5 million bond. 34-year-old Jeremy Mundine is charged with first-degree intentional homicide. Prosecutors say Mundine had two previous domestic abuse cases involving the victim in the homicide, including one earlier this month in Rock County. Mundine claims he shot the woman in self-defense after struggling over a gun in the hotel room on Sunday. And U.S. Marshals have arrested a man in connection with a triple shooting on Halloween last year. Now, the marshals found 26-year-old Jeremy Briggs at a hotel on Haynes Road this morning. He was booked into the Dane County Jail on first charges of first-degree intentional homicide and attempted homicide. Now, the shooting happened at the Wexford Ridge apartment complex on the city's west side. One person was found dead and two teens were also injured but survived. And Edgewood says it is taking the city of Madison to federal court as a part of its ongoing dispute over the installation of lights on its athletic field. Now, neighbors of the school have fought the addition of the lights for years, claiming that the school hosting night games would lead to too much light pollution and noise in the neighborhood. Now, the school presented its final appeal to the city in January, but it was ultimately denied. And in a letter to Edgewood families, President Mike Elliott says that the decision is forcing them to file a suit in federal court, alleging unfair treatment over the past 3 months. And while parts of the country are seeing snow for the first time in a long time, some of the South are excited about it. Check out this video in Louisville, Kentucky. Locals say this mailman's name is Tyrone Gore. And on his way down the stairs from his front porch, he stops to do a little cartwheel into the snow and then plops right there down to make a snow angel. Well, the time right now is 8:07. Coming up, how a group of friends tried to pose as seniors so they could get their second COVID vaccine. And you're taking a live look over the Capitol this morning. Austin is tracking your Saturday morning forecast. That's just ahead.
News 3 Now, your vaccine information headquarters.
Sir Jenian's 91-year history means you pay $91 for installation no matter how many rooms you carpet. Get carpet and pad, your furniture moved, and your old carpet recycled. Our competitors can't match it. Ask about 18-month financing. Local, sustainable, Sir Jenian's.
Is your credit score getting in the way of things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit help you borrow up to $10,000. So check your eligibility on netcredit.com today without affecting your credit score. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
Habitat Dane County provides long-term stability through affordable home ownership, creating the spaces where learning grows, the places to rest, the spots to gather, the areas to play safely. Strengthen our community. Support Habitat Dane County.
Madison Magazine's Restaurant Week is new and updated for 2021. Participating restaurants will provide a three-course menu at a special price for dining in at the restaurant or for takeout that you can enjoy at home. Dining with a choice. Don't miss Restaurant Week 2021, February 22nd through the 27th. Brought to you by the Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund, helping veterans, elderly, and disabled neighbors in need. For Restaurant Week menus and details, visit madisonmagazine.com.
The Great American Sales Event at your local Ford store has just been extended. Don't miss out on 1,000 President's Day cash on top of other offers on Ford F-150. With deals on America's workhorse, now's a great time to buy. Hurry in or shop online before March 1st. That's right, we've added days to get 1,000 President's Day cash on a 2020 Ford F-150 for $7,250 in total value. Hurry, the Great American Sales Event ends soon.
I grew up working in my family's supper clubs. This is where it started with us as far as the fish that we serve at Culver's today. We source the finest cod and batter each fillet by hand and always cook it to order. That beautiful golden brown color and flaky on the inside. The fish fry is a Midwest tradition. It's about families coming together. I love bringing this tradition to guests everywhere. Mom and Dad would be proud. Welcome to Delicious.
You make plans. What to wear, where to go, when to go, what to bring. And then the weather changes everything. Let News 3 Now First Warn Weather prepare you for what's coming. First, fast, and accurately, so you can plan your life. News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Welcome back. We have a bright and sunny Saturday ahead of us. Cold temperatures this morning, but warmer temperatures not too far away, especially by the time we reach next week. We're talking mild conditions with 30s and 40s. But first, we have to get through an alert day. That's going to be for Sunday, as we're expecting around 1 to 3 inches of snowfall. And that is likely going to lead to some slick road conditions as well. Now, our high-resolution radar doesn't show much here today. And again, you're going to see quite a bit of sunshine, especially throughout these morning hours. A little bit of some cloud cover towards the end of the day with mostly cloudy skies sneaking through tonight. Now, our temperatures, they really fell last night. It's much colder than what it was here just 24 hours ago. We're looking at temperatures below zero even right now. It's 11 below in Lone Rock. In Madison, currently 2 degrees below zero. But we're going to see a quick warm up. By noon, we're looking at upper teens and low 20s. Wind speeds, they're very calm this morning. So this is actually great news for us. With the calm conditions, that means our temperatures are matching the wind chills. If you throw on a 5-10 mile per hour breeze, then we're talking double digits below zero for the wind chills. Since we're not really seeing that for most of us, that does mean that generally our temperatures are still below zero, but barely. Now, it does look like our high temperature trend does show warmer days ahead of us. We're even looking at mid to upper 30s. And some low 40s. Tuesday is the day that I have had circled for quite some time, and that continues to be the trend. It's going to really be pretty mild on Tuesday, again, with those upper 30s and low 40s. Now let's switch gears, talk about what we're expecting with snowfall coming up here. It does look like we're gonna see, again, a lot of sunshine today, a little bit more cloud cover in the afternoon, and then overnight tonight, we are gonna see quite a bit of some cloud cover moving back into the area. And then by the time we reach tomorrow, most of our models are holding off until the afternoon hours. One or two, however, have sped things up, so there's that possibility to see some lighter snow showers in the morning, but most of the accumulating snowfall will be later on in the day, and especially overnight Sunday night. That's what we're looking at, around 1 to 3 inches of accumulation. That's going to cause a slick commute here later on Sunday as well as Monday morning. So that is currently our main concern right now. That's why we have issued that alert day as well. Again, 1 to 3 inches, not a ton of overwhelming snow by any means, but you don't need much to really cause issues on the roads. Now, the 10-day forecast, this does look actually pretty nice overall after we get through that snow chance for tomorrow. Then we're going to warm things right back up. We're looking at mid to upper 30s and low 40s. Quite a dry week as well before we see that next snow chance returning for next Saturday and Sunday.
All right, Austin, thank you so much. Well, body camera video released on Friday shows deputies scolding two women in Orange County, Florida, who tried to pose as seniors so they could get their second dose of a COVID vaccine. Take a look.
You know what you have done? You've stolen a vaccine from somebody that needs it more than you. And now you're not going to get your second one. So that's a whole waste of time we just wasted here on this. And we're not even sure if they're going to press charges against you and take you to jail right now. So we're at that point right here. But just for your selfishness of stealing a vaccine.
Well, the Florida Department of Health said two women came to the site on Wednesday, quote, dressed up as grannies so they could receive their shot. Right now, Florida is only vaccinating those 65 and older, as well as healthcare workers. These women are 44 and 34. Ultimately, the two were given a trespassing warning. And Senator Lindsey Graham is planning to spend the weekend with former President Trump at Mar-a-Lago, trying to mend fences. The South Carolina Republican says he's concerned the rift between Trump and Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell will damage the GOP's chances to win back the Senate or make gains in the House in 2022. And an Illinois police officer is grateful to be alive after a semi almost hit him on the highway. Check out this dramatic video. On the left of your screen, you can see a police car parked. And right after the officer comes out, this huge semi loses control and heads straight toward him. The local police department posted the video on its Facebook with a caption that said in part, "This is why it's so important to slow down and move over when you see emergency vehicles on the roadways." And the time right now is 8:14. Coming up before the next round of snow comes through our area, why you should make sure your snowblower is safe to use. And there are several new shows and movies to check out this weekend. Will Loper shares his three and three things to watch. That's coming up next in our trending news on News 3 Now this Saturday morning.
You know, if he keeps talking to you like that, you should just dump him.
Great night's sleep starts on a new Beautyrest from Steinhoffels. Right now, you can save up to $800 on Beautyrest Black adjustable base sets, plus get $200 in Steinhoffels cash. Beautyrest Queen mattresses start at only $17.99. Beautyrest Black combines the latest in sleep technology and luxury to give you the best night's sleep possible. And with Steinhoffels' special 60-month financing and free delivery, it's even more affordable. Steinhoffels is your new mattress destination.
The ups and downs of frequent mood swings can take you to deep depressive lows or give you unusually high energy even when depressed. Overwhelmed by bipolar 1? Ask about Vraylar. Some medicines only treat the lows or highs. Vraylar effectively treats depression, acute manic, and mixed episodes of bipolar 1 in adults. Full spectrum relief for all bipolar 1 symptoms with just one pill once a day. Elderly patients with dementia-related psychosis have an increased risk of death or stroke. Call your doctor about unusual changes in behavior or suicidal thoughts. Antidepressants can increase these in children and young adults. Report fever, stiff muscles, or confusion, which may mean a life-threatening reaction, or uncontrollable muscle movements, which may be permanent. Side effects may not appear for several weeks. High cholesterol and weight gain, high blood sugar, which can lead to coma or death, may occur. Movement dysfunction, sleepiness, and stomach issues are common side effects. When bipolar 1 overwhelms, Vraylar helps smooth the ups and downs.
Madison Magazine's Restaurant Week is new and updated for 2021. Participating restaurants will provide a three-course menu at a special price for dining in at the restaurant or for takeout that you can enjoy at home. Dining with a choice. Don't miss Restaurant Week 2021, February 22nd through the 27th. Additional support provided by Wisconsin Beef Council and E&J Gala Winery. For Restaurant Week menus and details, visit madisonmagazine.com.
Dear winter, I'm coming. My squad of 15 vehicles with all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive is ready to take you on. Safety's the name of my game, so you better bundle up. Toyota.
Right now, you can get $1,500 customer cash on a new 2021 Highlander or Highlander Hybrid. Find yours at toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
And you've dealt with that, right?
Good morning, Cold start here on our Saturday, but we're going to see temperatures recovering back into the low to mid 20s a little bit later on. And that beautiful sunshine, well, that's going to be sticking around for at least the first half of today. A little bit more cloud cover will sneak through later on in the afternoon. Now, our weekend forecast, low to mid 20s today, back in the 30s for tomorrow. But tomorrow is also an alert day, as we are expecting around 1 to 3 inches of accumulation. And that is looking to fall here generally in the afternoon and evening and overnight hours on Sunday night. Now, our temperatures again, very cold to start things off, below zero for most of us, but we're going to see a quick warm up. We're going to see temperatures back in the upper teens and low 20s just by the time we reach noon, thanks to the help with a lot of sunshine here on our Saturday.
Good. That might be a nice day to go out and get a nice little walk. What do you think, Austin?
Yeah, I couldn't agree more, to be honest. It's going to be a great day to just get outside, soak in the sunshine before the cloud cover and snow returns tomorrow.
All right. Thank you so much. Well, before the next round of snow comes through, make sure your snowblower is safe to use. The Toro Company is recalling about 6,700 of these snowblowers because of an amputation hazard. Now, the model number is right there on your screen. No injuries have been reported. Now, these models are sold in store and online at Home Depot and Ace Hardware. Country music legend Dolly Parton is turning down a statue in her honor. She asked state lawmakers to remove a new bill that would put up a statue of her on Tennessee State Capitol grounds. Now, Parton said, given all that is going on in the world right now, now is not the appropriate time to put her on a pedestal. A tweet posted to her account on Thursday says that she is honored, but she does not want the bill passed. Now, Parton said she would be open to the idea of a statue in several years, but for now, she'll continue to make Tennessee proud. And there's clearly no shortage of films and shows streaming right now. Our Will Loper shares a few of the best in this weekend's three things to watch.
My mom says that you're homeless. Is that true?
No, I'm not homeless. I'm just houseless. Not the same thing, right?
No.
Newly streaming on Hulu this week is the film Nomadland.
You are one of those lucky people that can travel anywhere.
Yes, ma'am, I know.
And they sometimes call you nomads.
Frances McDormand plays Fern, a woman who lives out of her van as a modern-day nomad, meeting others living the same lifestyle on her travels.
One of the things I love most about this life is that there's no final goodbye. I've met hundreds of people out here, and I don't ever say a final goodbye. Let's just say I'll see you down the road.
Nomadland is streaming on Hulu now.
The court has appointed me to be your legal guardian.
What?
You have to come with me. And remember, I'm here to help.
Newly streaming on Netflix is the dark comedy, I Care a Lot.
Marla Grayson, you've had amazing success. What's your secret?
There is no secret, Peter.
She forces them into the home, auctions off their house,
and uses the proceeds to pay herself.
Because caring is my job.
Rosamund Pike plays a woman who swindles the elderly out of their assets, but her scheming ways catch up to her when one of her wards has connections to a violent gangster, played by Peter Dinklage.
Hello, Marla Grayson. I don't like you.
You only just met me.
There's two types of people in this world. Predators and prey.
I Care a Lot is streaming on Netflix now.
Oh, you're in trouble now.
Every superhero comes to us with a purpose.
And finally, for the kids, newly streaming on Disney Plus is the film Flora and Ulysses.
We don't always see it at first, because we don't always know where to look.
If you like superhero films but think more of them should really be squirrels, this is the movie you've been waiting for.
People look to the skies for someone to save them. So the universe sent us Ulysses.
Flora and Ulysses is streaming on Disney Plus now.
Can you talk? Okay, that's that's not really talking, but still!
Happy watching. Those are the three things you need to watch. And this is Will Loper for News 3 Now this morning.
Well, Disney Plus is making a rainbow connection. All five seasons of Jim Henson's The Muppet Show are now on the streaming service. Disney Plus says this is the first time the fourth and fifth seasons will be released on home entertainment. Fans of Kermit the Frog, Miss Piggy, and Fonzie the Bear can also watch The Muppet Movie and The Muppet Christmas Carol, also on Disney Plus. And Madame Tussauds has updated its Meghan Markle wax figure after her recent baby news. The Wax Museum's Sydney location posted this photo of Markle featuring a baby bump on social media. The addition to the bump, Markle's wax doppelganger, went to the Sydney Zoo for a maternity photo shoot. Now, Meghan and the Duchess of Sussex and her husband, Prince Harry, announced on Sunday that they are expecting their second child. In its post, Madame Tussauds congratulated the couple and the soon-to-be a big brother, Archie. And IHOP is canceling its National Pancake Day celebration, or at least altering it for now. In years past, the restaurant chain has given away free flapjacks on Fat Tuesday, also known as Mardi Gras. Executives decided against that this year due to the pandemic. So instead, customers can get a free short stack anytime in April. Members of IHOP's email club will see an IOU for the free hotcakes to hit their inboxes. Customers not on the list can download a coupon on the company's website, but that version of the deal requires a $10 minimum purchase. Now, the promotion will also apply for those to-go orders and delivery orders. And coming up next on News 3, we'll keep you updated on the latest numbers from health officials regarding the coronavirus as it spreads across the country and right here in our state. Plus, a hefty fine you could receive if you don't wear your mask at the airport. We'll be right back.
Thanks for calling 1-800-GOT-JUNK.
Do you make junk disappear?
Yes, ma'am.
When?
Now.
We make junk disappear. All you have to do is point.
Millions of customers are leaving their providers and switching to Spectrum. And if you have satellite, it's not hard to see why. Because unlike satellite, Spectrum gives you all the services you need, like internet and TV, from one provider.
They do?
Yeah, they do. And Spectrum has the fastest download speeds with the most reliable performance. Get Spectrum internet with speeds at 200 megabits for $44.99 a month. Call 833-909-4499. Spectrum wins on TV, too. Unlike satellite, Spectrum doesn't have an ugly dish to install. And you get exclusive premium original content with Spectrum Originals.
Wow, really?
Really. Plus, Spectrum has more free HD and free on demand. Get Spectrum TV from $44.99 a month. Call 833-909-4499. And unlike satellite providers, Spectrum doesn't have contracts or early termination fees. We'll even buy out your current contract up to $500. Switch to America's fastest growing internet, TV, and voice provider. Get Spectrum internet and TV from $44.99 a month each. Ask about our easy self-install options. Call 833-909-4499.
Your parents spent years taking care of you, but as the years go by, it becomes your turn to take care of them. This might mean trusting a nursing home, which promises to care for them as cherished loved ones. But if the nursing home you've chosen is not keeping their promise, we can help. If your parents have been injured in a nursing home, call Habish, Habish and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
Every new smile starts at Aspen Dental, with custom-crafted dentures made in our on-site labs and ready in as little as a day. We give you unparalleled safety at every visit, natural-looking results you'll love, and options for every budget. Now, during our Everyday Smiles event, get dentures for only $29 per month per arch, 60 months financing with total payments of $16.61. Find every reason to smile every day at Aspen Dental. Call 1-800-ASPEN-DENTAL or book today at aspendental.com.
The Great American Sales event at your local Ford store has just been extended. Don't miss out on Flex Buy with 0% APR for 66 months plus 1,000 President's Day cash on top of other offers on select SUVs. With added days of deals on America's best-selling brand, now's a great time to buy. Hurry in or shop online before March 1st. Choose Flex Buy on a 2020 Edge with 0% APR for 66 months. And with President's Day cash, get a total 4,000 cash back. Hurry. The Great American Sales event ends soon.
that time of year again.
How can we help?
Could you haul this away for me?
Oh, it's gone.
There was stuff here. Amazing.
When you want junk to disappear, all you have to do is point.
Right now, while local veterinarians say COVID is making it difficult to care for our pets.
This is News 3 Now This Morning.
Good morning, everyone. It is Saturday, February 20th. I'm Taylor Lazenby, and let's get straight to our weather with Austin. Good morning, Austin.
Good morning. You know, it's a very cold start out there, but we are going to see mild temperatures this afternoon compared to what we saw these last few weeks. It's still going to be a solid 10 degrees below where we should be, but those average temperatures and even above average temperatures, not too far away. They're actually going to be sliding through over this next work week. Three things to know: low to mid 20s for today, about 1 to 3 inches of snowfall on Sunday afternoon and the nighttime hours as well. That has prompted an alert day here for Sunday and Sunday night. And then mild conditions afterwards, 30s and even a chance for 40s by the time we reach Tuesday. Now we're looking at our temperature 24-hour change. So this is the temperatures right now compared to yesterday, the difference between those. And we're seeing a solid 5 to 10 degree drop compared to yesterday morning. So I mentioned how it's cold out there. It most definitely is. In fact, our actual temperatures are even a few degrees below zero. So that is important. If you're heading out early this morning, make sure you bundle up. And the day planner does show a quick warm up back into the upper teens and low 20s by the time we do reach the noon hour. And then just another quick peek at your first warn traffic right now. It does look like we are still looking good to go right here in the Madison area. Major arteries in and out of town still looking pretty solid. But again, those side roads and streets still a bit slushy with how cold it's been and the snowfall that we've seen.
All right, Austin, thank you so much. Well, cases are currently heading in the right direction in Wisconsin. For a week straight, there have been fewer than 1,000 new COVID cases per day. More than 40,000 doses of the vaccine have been administered in the last 24 hours. And on the state level, about 13% of Wisconsin's population has received their first dose of a vaccine. Only about 5% of the state has completed both doses. And right here in Dane County, things are going a little better. Around 16% of the county's 500,000 residents have received at least one dose. Around 7.5% of them have gotten both. And the Wisconsin Department of Health Services is launching a new website next month. It aims to help people find places to get their vaccines and when an appointment becomes available. However, DHS says the site won't be a comprehensive list of all vaccination options. Healthcare systems like pharmacies like Walgreens and local health departments may already have their own scheduling software in place. And it's been more than 2 weeks since the federal transportation face mask requirement was put in place. So far, the TSA says they have had fewer than 1,000 reports of violations. Now, the agency is enforcing a national requirement to wear masks when traveling on planes, trains, and buses. If you don't, the first offense is $250. Repeat offenders could be fined $1,500. And if it's provided, they'll use it. That's what the CDC researchers have found when it comes to providing workers with personal protective equipment. Now, the study looked at survey answers from workers just last June who didn't use PPE at work before the pandemic. 29% used PPE if they had to bring it themselves. But researchers found use doubled if the PPE was provided. More than half of those who used PPE in the study were required to do so by their employers. And experts say food and food packaging are highly unlikely to spread COVID. That's according to the FDA and the Department of Agriculture and the CDC. The three agencies sent out a reminder on Thursday stressing the lack of credible evidence to suggest that food or its packaging are associated with the transmission of the virus. The FDA says COVID is a respiratory illness spread from person to person, different from a foodborne virus that can make people sick through contaminated foods. And while we aren't seeing the same COVID transmission in cats and dogs, the pandemic itself is a burden on the Madison area veterinarians, and it's impacting how they are able to take care of our pets. Vets didn't make the final cut for the next tier of vaccinations here in Wisconsin. Our Madeline O'Neill explains why and what they say would help.
Hey, how are you?
As our furry companions help us.
And certainly help with families that have are experiencing loneliness,
as well as mental health issues.
Okay.
Veterinarians like Dr. Kai Shu are here to help them.
Hi, buddy.
Fred's assistance goes beyond his best friend.
Our relationship is very close, to say the least.
To all of Janesville.
He's keeping our community safe, and we're doing our part to try and keep Fred comfortable.
Good dog. Yeah.
Along with the bad guys.
Okay, big guy.
Canine Fred is fighting cancer.
But he has just done really amazingly well.
Without his oncology appointments.
I'd probably be without my partner.
And whether they fight crime or not, that's a thought most pet owners don't want to imagine.
Emergency clinics have really seen a huge increase in wait time.
Chu says at the same time the pandemic is discouraging already burdened workers, it's encouraging record pet adoptions.
So we've got this high increased demand of caseload, as well as a struggling workforce, and that's really impacted our ability to care for patients.
More preventative care is getting shifted to urgent care facilities, meaning diseases get diagnosed later on, as other clinics feel the weight of the pandemic as well.
It's been really hard. I would say most days we turn people away.
The goal is to be a place to turn. WISCARES, a branch of UW, offers subsidized care for people experiencing homelessness or financial constraints.
Because of the work we do, I feel like we can keep families together, including their animals.
Caseloads are up.
Just due to COVID and job loss and loss of revenue and increased hardship, a lot more people qualify for our services.
The veterinary industry in general is busy.
Thank you, Pop.
At Precision Veterinary, the low-cost clinic has had to stop accepting new patients for their spay and neuter services because of health protocols.
And it leaves us feeling really helpless too, like when we can't, you know, help when we get calls coming in, and, you know, especially when they're like, well, I've tried everywhere else.
They're continuing wellness services with the precautions they can take.
This isn't the sort of job you can do remotely.
But say vaccinations would make a world of difference for veterinary care in general, preventing potentially devastating hospital closures from staff needing to quarantine.
For a massive increased demand, massive crash in supply, now you've created a huge problem where somebody dies that didn't need to.
To keep helping our pets, Shu says the vaccine could go a long way in helping them.
The community needs us more so than ever. Avoid the
lymphatic obstruction. Now, Dr. Shu says veterinary workers are critical from the health perspective as well, because they are at the front lines looking at pets who could have the next emerging virus. Well, coming up here, we have new details in President Biden's American Rescue Plan. Plus, why some Dane County has some of the stiffest enforcements in the state. That's next on News 3 Now this Saturday morning.
At U.S. Cellular, we believe everyone deserves 5G. Not just New York and L.A., but the millions of people in cities like yours. Like Milwaukee, Rock Island, and Des Moines. That's why we're including 5G on all plans, no extra charge. Because everywhere matters, like Oconomowoc, Claysville, Prineville, Monopoly. U.S. Cellular has included 5G on all plans, no extra charge. Get unlimited data as low as $30 a month. U.S. Cellular.
You thought you were the only ones who'd go someplace just because you liked the name of the town. The only ones who didn't just want to see the world, but needed to explore every corner of it. You thought you were the only ones, until you discovered others just like you. Jeep Cherokee, there's only one.
Right now, get 0% financing for 84 months or $4,750 total cash allowance on select 2021 Jeep Cherokee models. Hurry to the Jeep President's Day event today.
The new Detroit style from Pizza Hut, where the sauce goes on last. Yeah, you heard me. Last. That's what keeps the crust light and airy. It's kind of blowing my mind right now. Try the new Detroit style today. No one out-pizzas the Hut.
Wisconsin weather can be frustrating. Get the latest forecast, alerts, and detailed traffic reports from the News 3 Now team. Download the Channel 3000 Firstborn app, sponsored by Group Health Cooperative, and be prepared for anything headed our way.
Madison Magazine's Restaurant Week is new and updated for 2021. Participating restaurants will provide a three-course menu at a special price for dining in at the restaurant or for takeout that you can enjoy at home, dining with a choice. Don't miss Restaurant Week 2021, February 22nd through the 27th. Additional support provided by Wisconsin Beef Council and E&J Gala Winery. For Restaurant Week menus and details, visit madisonmagazine.com.
This is the new Ergo Smart Base from Tempur-Pedic, and it responds to snoring automatically. So no more nudging your partner or opting for the couch. Because the Tempur Ergo Smart Base is our first system that detects snoring and automatically adjusts to help reduce it. Your best sleep, all night, every night.
And right now, save up to $500 on Tempur-Pedic adjustable mattress sets. Denver Mattress, the easiest way to get the right Tempur-Pedic.
It's been 10 years since Wisconsin's controversial Act 10 legislation was born. To waves of backlash, News 3 Now examines how Act 10 has reshaped education in our state. Has it had a significant impact on how well students learn? Monday at 10. Every day, News 3 Now investigates, taking action to discover and report the facts to make sure your voice is heard. That's why News 3 Now investigates.
And welcome back. I'm meteorologist Austin Kopnitsky with a look at your weekend forecast. Today, you can expect a lot of sunshine. That is one nice aspect about today, but we're going to stay on the cooler side of things. Average high temperature today has risen to 33 degrees. We're going to be a solid 10 below that with a high of 23. And then for tomorrow, we finally do start to see the warmer temperatures, but also tomorrow's an alert day. We're looking at around 1 to 3 inches of snowfall, especially in the afternoon, evening, and overnight hours Sunday night. Most of the snow should be wrapped up on Monday morning, but we're still looking at some slick road conditions that we are expecting. Now, our temperature is still below zero. Wisconsin Dells, one of the quickest recoveries that we've seen so far this morning. They're currently at 0 degrees. And then later on this afternoon, again, we're going to see those low to mid 20s. Thankfully, the wind speed's just not a problem here for today.
All right, Austin, thank you so much. Well, President Biden's American Rescue Plan moved through the House with its key pieces intact on Friday. The $1.9 trillion stimulus includes a $15 an hour minimum wage, as it was pieced together by the House Budget Committee. Now, Americans making about $75,000 or less a year would get a one-time direct payment of $1,400. The relief package also includes more money for small businesses struggling during the pandemic, and federal unemployment benefits will include a $400 a week increase. And there's money for schools to reopen. Now, the bill is expected to go to the House floor later next week. And businesses and individuals are on the hook for almost $200,000 in COVID-19 public health order fines in Dane County. Our investigative reporter Naomi Coles tracked down the records that show Dane County has some of the stiffest enforcements in the state.
It's a combination of not understanding, not thinking that the order applies to them.
A few repeat offenders and a lot of large gatherings.
We want individuals to comply with the order, but when they don't, we feel the need that we need to either issue citations or bring them into court.
Here's the fast facts. 40 people in Dane County are facing $137,000 in maximum fines for large gathering violations. That's before court fees. At least 90% of them are college students. On the business side, 63 businesses are facing more than $50,000 in citations for public health order violations. That's more than Milwaukee, where the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel reported $28,000 in COVID-related fines for businesses.
I believe in fall, we switched to more a robust prosecution that we would take an enforcement action because people weren't voluntarily complying with the order.
A dance studio in Oregon is currently on the hook for almost half of those fines and joined a lawsuit against the county in protest. That lawsuit argues the fines are based off an unconstitutional ordinance the county passed in May.
The county board has to be involved and vote on it. And until the county board does that, none of the orders that the health department has issued are enforceable. So any fines or any enforcement actions so far are, in our view, illegal.
The city attorney handling public health order prosecutions in the county says voluntary compliance is the goal, but public safety comes first.
We obviously want to slow the spread of the virus, and our orders are in place to do that.
For News 3 Investigates, I'm Naomi Coles.
Well, those fines issued don't necessarily mean fines paid. Now, the city tells Naomi a lot of those could be reduced in court, and some citations could go away if businesses don't have further violations. For more on these fines and the lawsuit challenging them, we have more online at channel3000.com. Well, coming up, why some say the COVID vaccine has caused the price of gas to increase. And you're taking a live look over the Capitol this morning. Austin is tracking our Saturday morning forecast. We'll be right back. But first, if you have a little one that's turning three soon, please let us know so we can share and celebrate with them.
Look Who's Three is sponsored by Three Bears Resort, indoor water park and conference center in Warrens, Wisconsin.
Hey, there's a new cow in town, Wisco. Crazy good pizza, wings, and custom-made mac and cheese from a new virtual kitchen and your friends at Monk's Bar & Grill. For takeout or delivery, 7 days a week. Order the goodness today at wiscowpizza.com.
The most important thing in the Chevy Equinox is not forward collision alert or automatic emergency braking. No, the most important thing in the Equinox isn't any of the advanced safety features we've put into it. It's what you put into it. Chevy Safety Assist, standard on every 2021 Chevy Equinox.
Get a $4,000 cash allowance on most 2021 Equinox models. Plus, current Chevy owners with an eligible GM credit card get an additional $1,750 total allowance. See your Badgerland Chevy dealer today.
Maintenance fee, ATM fee. Can I hide in your fort?
Sure, but the fort fee is 10 cookies.
Psst. Need a place to hide from fees? With a BMO Harris Smart Advantage account, you can get cash with nearly as many fee-free ATMs in the U.S. as the three largest banks combined. And no monthly maintenance fee. Huh, did you hear that? No monthly maintenance fee.
Fort fees are subject to the governing bodies of the fort.
She did not learn that from me.
When a bank helps you make real financial progress, that's the BMO effect. And right now, get a $200 bonus when you open a new BMO Harris Smart Advantage account.
Did you know that 178 million Americans are missing at least one tooth?
It's true.
That's why at Affordable Dentures and Implants, we only focus on tooth replacement solutions.
Whether it's a single tooth, full dentures, or dental implants, we have an experienced dentist who can create a new smile just for you.
At a price that's affordable.
Because at Affordable Dentures and Implants, we want you to go ahead and smile.
Prices? Then get more ways to save at Pick and Save, where you can find personalized coupons, weekly deals, and rewards like fuel points. All for prices that are lower than low. On food that's fresher than fresh. Pick and Save. Fresh for everyone.
Hey, there's a new cow in town, Wisco. Crazy good pizza, wings, and custom-made mac and cheese from a new virtual kitchen and your friends at Monk's Bar & Grill. For takeout or delivery, 7 days a week. Order the goodness today at wiscowpizza.com.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Welcome back and good morning. We do have an alert day to talk about this morning. Now, the alert day is for tomorrow, especially in the afternoon, evening, and overnight hours Sunday night. Now, by the time we reach Monday morning, most of the snow will be gone in terms of falling out of the sky, but still watch out for those slick roads. We have issued those alert days, or that rather, alert day for Sunday. Now, today, we're going to see a lot of sunshine. We're already seeing that this morning. More cloud cover a little bit later on in the afternoon and evening hours, but for most of today, you can expect a lot of blue skies overhead, and that's really going to help with these temperatures that have been oh so cold, but we're going to finally start to see them really warming up here over this next week. Currently, not so much. We're still at 2 below right here in Madison. You will definitely need to bundle up. Even later on this week, after the warm-up, we're only going to reach those upper 30s and low 40s at a point, so you're still going to need those layers, but just not as many layers as what we have seen. Thankfully, our wind speeds are extremely calm this morning, so you jump on over over to our wind chill map, and that's basically just matching the temperatures here for this morning. We're really not seeing much of a difference at all from our temperatures to the wind chills, and that's just because we're just not seeing anything in terms of the wind speeds. But our high temperature trend shows that warm up, 40s on the map right now, especially for this next Tuesday. And we're also looking at a dry streak here from Monday all the way till that next Friday before we see that next precipitation chance arriving for the next weekend. We're already talking about next weekend, but first we have to get through a little bit of snow this weekend. That's going to fall here again tomorrow. Today, lots of sunshine, afternoon cloud cover. Tomorrow, however, by the time we reach around noon, we're going to start to see those snow showers developing. They're going to continue into the early part of Sunday night as well, wrapping up by Monday morning, and we're still looking at about 1 to 3 inches of snowfall. So not an overwhelming amount of snow, but again, as we've seen, we don't need much snowfall at all here to cover these roadways, especially with how cold it actually has been as of late. Now, another look at your 7 to 10 day forecast, and it looks pretty solid during the next work week. Again, we have that next chance for precipitation this Sunday and then next weekend afterwards. From Monday to Friday, right now, just a few chances for some flurries here and there, warmer than average temperatures as well. Our average high right now is 33 degrees, and we're looking at mid to upper 30s, and Tuesday, 41 is our expected high right now. Did someone say heat wave?
Heat wave. I'm excited, Austin. I'm excited. Tuesday.
Yeah.
I'm just circling
I cannot
that day,
wait.
Like you said, Tuesday.
Yeah, me too.
All right, thank you so much. Well, you may have noticed the prices of gas are on the rise. AAA officials say the average price in Wisconsin right now has jumped up about 15 cents in just the last day and closer to 25 cents in just the last week. Now, there is a combination of factors causing that spike. Now, over the last 2 to 3 months, prices have been increasing because of optimism fueled by the vaccine and people feeling like things might get back to normal later this year. But we're also seeing the effects of a winter storm that wiped out power and stopped production in Texas.
That is both on the production and the refinery side, not directly impacting us because the gas that we get here in the Midwest doesn't come from Texas, but it does have kind of a ripple effect on the national market and prices throughout the country.
Now, it's also about supply and demand. The stockpile of gas and oil that was building up during 2020 from stay-at-home orders is starting to draw down, and demand has increased slightly. And new research looks at which foods lower the risk of one of the most common types of cancer and how the pandemic is impacting preventative care. Chris Martinez has a look at some of today's top health stories.
A large number of Medicare beneficiaries went without routine vaccinations because of the coronavirus pandemic. The CDC says weekly vaccination rates for viruses, including diphtheria and tetanus, dropped 89% in the first half of 2020 compared to the same period the year before. More people are being hospitalized for serious food allergies, but fewer are dying. Researchers in the UK found death rates from allergic reactions dropped by more than half over the past 20 years. The study also found cow's milk is the single most common cause of fatal allergic reactions. And what you eat could affect your risk for colorectal cancer. Research published in JAMA Network Open found that lower risk for colorectal cancer was associated with higher intakes of fiber, calcium, and yogurt, and lower intakes of alcohol and red meat. Those are some of the week's top health stories. Chris Martinez, CBS News, Los Angeles.
Well, stick with News 3 all weekend long. Amanda will have today's top stories coming up tonight at 6 and at 10. But first, how this one family is turning frigid into fun. We'll be back in a moment.
Sunroom saving season is here. Four Seasons has great solutions to beat the backyard blues and save 20 to 30%. Let CoolView show you how to tame your backyard and improve your lifestyle. Call for a free backyard survey, design, and quote.
Is your credit score getting in the way of the things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit offer fast and flexible lending. Borrow up to $10,000 and choose repayment terms that work for you. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
Winning Motor Trend Truck of the Year 3 times in a row.
That had never been done before. Then again, neither had a 12-inch touchscreen or 1,000 pound-feet of torque, or being the only pickup on Car and Driver's 10 Best list. Never been done before. It's just kind of our thing.
During the Ram President's Day event, get 0% financing for 72 months, plus $3,750 total bonus cash on the 2021 Ram 1500.
Madison Magazine's Restaurant Week is new and updated for 2021. Participating restaurants will provide a three-course menu at a special price for dining in at the restaurant or for takeout that you can enjoy at home, dining with a choice. Don't miss Restaurant Week 2021, February 22nd through the 27th. Brought to you by the Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund, helping veterans, elderly, and disabled neighbors in need. For Restaurant Week menus and details, visit madisonmagazine.com.
Do you take daily prescription pain medications, but they don't help enough? Do you want more options to better manage chronic pain? University of Wisconsin-Madison STAMP Study offers free, safe, therapeutic programs to address chronic pain. The programs occur once a week for 8 weeks and pays up to $340. Call 608-212-6902 today. Again, that's 608-212-6902.
We drive everywhere to help our son reach his dream of becoming an elite swimmer. So we enrolled in the Know Your Drive program with American Family Insurance. It gives us discounts for safe driving, which comes in handy, no matter where his dreams take him. With Know Your Drive, save up to 20% and get closer to your dreams.
American Family Insurance.
Insure carefully, dream fearlessly.
Sunroom saving season is here. Four Seasons has great solutions to beat the backyard blues and save 20 to 30%. Let Coolview show you how to tame your backyard and improve your lifestyle. Call for a free backyard survey, design, and quote.
Before you make plans, download the Channel 3000 First Warn weather app.
Finally, this morning, roll with the punches and make the most of it. Those are the rules, and they apply to a family in Lakeville, Minnesota, where temperatures are bone-chilling these days. As Boyd Hubbard reports, the family figured out a way to turn frigid into fun.
On summer days, positive people make lemonade from lemons. But these days,
minus 10.
Neighborhoods need a Jessica Montenegro to make rainbows from ice.
We've been loving the negative weather.
Temperatures down, and Jessica up to her neck in cold snap creativity.
You just really have to pack it in good.
And Igloo also teaching lessons.
Want to come in here, guys?
To Jessica's sons.
We're trying to find some more icicles.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Let's embrace every season, every temperature. Here's some freezing here.
Food coloring ice blocks made in cake pans.
Open it up a little bit. Voila.
Mortar made in buckets.
Oh, yeah, slush. Yep.
And magic made below zero.
Probably 2 minutes to freeze, yeah.
It's all done. Wait, we're going to eat pizza in it.
We're going to have the pizza delivery guy deliver it to the igloo.
In summer, Jessica's known to her neighbors for elaborate driveway chalk murals.
It's just an extension of sidewalk chalk, basically, yeah.
Makes the neighborhood a nice place to be.
A ray of positivity.
At least we have the sun.
For Jessica Montenegro, even on the coldest of days, the pluses outweigh the minuses.
I think it's going to be really cool.
Boyd Hubbard, Carol 11 News, Lakeville.
How cool is that? Well, Nestle is launching a vegan Kit Kat in 2021 called Kit Kat V. Now, Nestle owns the Kit Kat brand globally, except for in the United States, where it's owned by Hershey's. And the new vegan Kit Kats will be launched later in the year in several countries across the globe where Nestle owns the brand. Now, Nestle is helping people embrace a more plant-based diet with options across its wide range of food and beverages. Now, Austin, we talked last show if you would try this Kit Kat. Still, the answer is yes, maybe you would try it. What are you going with?
You know, I still think that I would try it. I'm open to testing it out, you know. And, I mean, again, I want to test out that Impossible Burger as well. I just want to see how close it tastes to the real actual Kit Kat or the real Whopper, you know. That's the thing for me.
I think they can do it. I could think they could do it. We'll have to hold out and see when it gets over here to the stateside.
I'm excited to try it out. I'm also excited for warmer temperatures next week. First of all, we have to get through the expecting tomorrow, most of which will fall in the afternoon and evening hours, and in the early nighttime hours. We're going to finish up here by Monday morning at around 1 to 3 inches of snowfall. 10-day forecast that shows that warm up Tuesday's high 41 degrees. Starting to keep those warmer temperatures around. I like it.
Have a good weekend, everyone. Amanda will start our news at 6 and at 10.